All right. I think mine's good.
Yeah, I think mine's good too. I
hate this thing fucking squeaks. What is the anti-squeaking oil?
WD-40.
Yeah. I gotta get some of that shit. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I saw on fucking Twitter this video went viral of Megan Fox was being interviewed.
Yeah.
And she was with Machine Gun Kelly. Excuse me.
So it's a newer interview.
It's a newer interview. It's actually like a last week type of interview, something like that. Yeah, of course. And the interviewer was like, oh, so Megan, are you guys going to be doing more videos, like video music video shoots together? Are you going to incorporate in each other's like business together more often? Mm-hmm. And she's like, her answer was, yes, definitely. Well, to be blunt, he's not going to be doing videos with whores anymore, but I do whatever daddy says. That's what she said.
Okay.
So everyone started ripping her apart.
Why?
They're like, oh, yeah, this is nice. Like, see what you grew up to be. I bet your father's proud of you. It's like, that's such a turnoff. It's like, y'all are some hating-ass motherfuckers. Bitches, like,
hating-ass bitches.
Bro, like, you guys, if she was saying that shit to them.
You, you'd be my hype.
I was going to say. Like,
you're so dumb.
That's such a hater thing. Like, everything was big hating hater on it. I didn't see one person like, oh, good for them. Like,
yeah, right.
Not a single one.
It, like, dude, I'm not going to say it's super normal, but having girls calling guys like daddy, I mean, it's not that strange. Yeah. I don't feel.
Yeah, I don't know. That's pretty normal to me, I think. Especially nowadays. I feel like things are more sexual than they've ever been, so.
And like, I don't know.
They're fucking young. They're hot. I don't know. Let them fucking get
successful.
Right.
They've already made it.
Yeah.
Now they're just fucking. I mean, yeah, what's wrong?
I don't know. People were being bitches about it. I was like, you guys are fucking losers.
I find that. The internet is pretty divided. I think it's pretty 50-50.
It definitely is.
Haters and,
yeah,
and lovers.
Yeah.
There are a lot of haters out there.
Yeah. Yeah, there is. Mm-hmm. Should probably make sure these mics are good. Start this bitch. Dude, I've been having these terrifying fucking dreams.
Really?
Yeah.
That's not good. What happens? Do you die?
A lot of death. But it's like me in really fucking weird situations. Like I'm like about to fall off an edge type of situation. And then someone shoves me. Like they're really dark. I don't know what's happening. But
I mean, like you wake up before you hit the ground.
Yeah. Sweating. Kind of like wicked fast heartbeat.
Gotta, like you're falling. I'm going to die. And as soon as you hit the ground, you wake up.
Yes. Mm-hmm. One of the times I hit the ground and I'm sitting there with my eyes open, just staring at the woods. Can't feel anything, but it's like, okay, so I actually died and I'm just sitting here now, like what's happening? And then I woke up and same thing. I was like, it's fucking weird, but weird. We should start this, right?
Yeah, let's go.
3, 2, 1.
I got a story to tell, you know that I cherish these. Hope it ain't too many feelings involved. In this bitch, stuntin', poppin' bottles, getting drunk with these bitches, and when they leave, they get followed. Fall asleep with that bitch, and really don't know much about her. Then she let us in, we take all of your shit, and when you wake up, she help you try to find it. I love her. I be with bitches, that be with bitches, that be with niggas with riches. I tell her, get him, she say, I got you. I say, no bitch, I say, get him. And they so pretty, and they hair lengthy, he hit it and sleep on her titties. And she give us the worry, come through with their cages to stick up. She scream like a victim, like you, feeling so silly, I smoke color.
So Lil Wayne and Kendrick talking about girls robbing niggas, does it for you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
What was your reaction when you first heard that song?
Honestly, I didn't listen to it the first time because it was at like a gathering. So I heard the beat and I was like, this sounds dope. This
it sounds
fire.
It goes hard.
Yeah.
It goes hard.
Dude, when I listened to it in the car, I was like, whoa.
It is a very hard song.
Yeah.
The first time I listened to it, I didn't know what to feel. I was like, this is a lot.
I thought it was dope as fuck. I love the storytelling like that, dude. That's my shit.
I agree, but it's like,
it's not good though.
It's not a good story.
Yeah. It's pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
But. Yeah. Fools do that shit, dude, you know?
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever gotten set up by a girl?
I got set up by a guy once that was pretending to be a girl. And then I showed up at his crib. I was young. And all right, so let me backtrack a little bit.
Yeah, let's get into this.
So, dude, I went to this restaurant with my family. This is years ago. Years ago. I think it was like my first or my second job. I was like 20, 19, you know? And there was this girl that was serving that I went to high school with. And we used to vibe in high school, but we never really talked. And then she was like, yo, we should talk. And I was like, word. So I started talking to her on Facebook. And out of nowhere, I got a text from a number. It's like, hey, it's me. Let's keep on chatting through here. So I was like, oh, is this you? Oh, I don't want to say her name. And she's like, yeah. I was like, word. So we talked for like 3 days, bro.
What the fuck?
3 fucking days. It was just like, we're just chatting, bro. It didn't really get sexual. We were just like getting to know each other. I was like, yeah, we should hang out. She was like, word.
That's a bit sociopathic.
It was crazy.
For it not to be her.
Hey, bro. Bro. And then things started getting weird one day. And I was like, I don't know. Like, I feel like this is kind of off. So I messaged her on Facebook. And she's like, we have not talked in 3 days. Oh, she's shit. Like, I have been waiting for you. And I was like, what the fuck? So I like reverse trace the number to an account and then reverse trace the account to the original number because it's like wasn't hidden. I figured it out.
Right.
I found out the kid. It was like some kid. I didn't even know the fucking kid. I didn't even know him. I don't know how he got my number. It was just like some kid that was from the neighborhood, but I never talked to him before. It wasn't even my friend. And then he was like, once I confronted him over text, he's like, yeah, it was me. I was just fucking with you. He thought it was really funny. So
3 days? That's not fucking.
It's
with
not
someone.
Funny.
That's sociopathic.
That's really fucked up. I found out where he lived, and then one night around 11 o'clock midnight, I showed up at his crib. I was like, "We're gonna fight," and he's like, "All right, shit, pull up." He's telling me for hours to pull up.
Yeah.
So I pulled up. He didn't tell me his address. I found his address out, and I used to be kind of gangsta back then.
Yeah.
A little bit. I don't know. Like I said,
I had those moments,
but
too.
I went kind of hard. I went kind of hard. Shit. Yep. So I showed up to his house, and I'm like, I'm outside. He's like, no, you're not. I'm like, where? Because I sent him a picture of his house. I'm like, because that's your dad right there. I'm gonna go and cave his shit in if you don't come the fuck outside right now. I'll fuck him up.
Right.
And he like came out. He was freaking out.
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah.
It is a little bro. It's a skinny ass little white kid, bro.
I think you've told part of the story.
Still in high school, bro.
Yeah.
I freaked out on him, bro. I started getting mad aggressive. He told his parents because he thought, because I lived in Lawrence and he was in Andover. So he thought I was just like some wannabe gangster, but I pulled up.
Yeah, no, of course.
So he told his parents, he's like, this guy's going to fucking kill me. He knows where I live. I'm like, word, because he didn't want to come outside that night.
Yeah.
So I was like, all right, word. I know that you go to this school. I know that you're still on the track team.
Right.
I know that track gets off at around 5:15. I know that you walk home because your parents work. I told him all this information that I found out. He's like, this dude knows my schedule. He's going to fucking kill me,
right,
bro.
Right.
He told his parents called the cops and then it was fucking ridiculous, bro.
His dad and his mom
were like, he's just an idiot, like don't, like they got my number and they called me and they're like, please forgive him, he's just an idiot, like we're so sorry, like he knows the whole story, like he shouldn't have been doing that to you, that's not right. And I was like, nah, I'm going to fucking kill him.
Right.
Like, I'm
going to fuck him up, bro. I was just going to say, that makes me 10 times angry. I have a very similar story.
To his parents, I'm like, I'm going to fucking kill him. Yeah. I am going to fuck up your son bad.
Right.
And I hung up and I left it at that. So his parents got the police involved. They got my parents involved. And they're like, don't fucking kill him. I was like, fine, I won't kill him.
Right.
They ended up grounding him for like 3 months. And like, they took away his phone and his Xbox. So I'm like, I'll just leave it at that.
Yeah.
I was
okay, good. So they did punish him for doing that fucking weirdo shit he did.
Yeah.
Okay.
They did.
That's good.
They did.
Well, actually, okay, I'd feel pretty justified.
I was gonna fucking hurt him. Bro, right, dude. I'm a nice guy and I'm really friendly, but I was kinda like at that time, I was just a little, I thought I was thugger than I am. I'm definitely wouldn't do that now.
I'm the exact same way, dude.
But
we've had very similar
bro,
I've been set up by a girl and a guy.
I don't like being set up. That shit bothered me so bad.
That is really sociopathic.
What's your story? Is it about, this is similar to mine or?
Yes and no. A lot of it is very similar and a lot is a little fucked up. I actually can't tell a lot of the story. Some people involved listen to this podcast.
Okay.
Now
I'm interested. Now you got to tell it.
Well, I
now
can
you
tell,
have to say it.
I can tell pieces of it. Okay, pieces are still wild. So
yeah, I'll take
I've been in a situation where I was, so in high school, this like tall, giant ass dude on the wrestling team, and I was like 2 inches shorter than I am now, smacked one of my ex's ass.
Yeah.
In class and like grabbed it and shit. And she told me when she came home from school that day. Mm-hmm. So I hit him up and I was like threatening to like kill him and beat the fuck out of him. And I was like, I'm going to fuck you up in school or outside of school. You choose where it is. Mm-hmm. I don't care if I get arrested for this shit. Mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. Long story short, I was texting his brother, not him. Yeah. I got the wrong phone number.
Okay.
And his brother was fucking with one of my other exes. So he thought it was about her.
Oh.
So he was actually wanting to fight me now.
Yeah, yeah.
And I didn't want to fight him. I wanted to fight his brother. But the fact I wanted to fight his brother pissed him off even more.
Yeah.
And he's the same size as his brother.
Yeah.
Long story short, I showed up. I had like 40 people with me. And by the time I got to the actual place to fight, there was 2 people with me. Everyone hung back and was being pussies. And it was him and his brother and 10 of their friends.
Yeah. Wow, your boy's dipped?
Of course, yeah.
Wow.
And I have to cut this out. Anal.
Right.
Unanal. So for a while, like, so I got there and I squared up against the kid who I originally wanted to fight.
Yeah.
And he was looking at me like, what the fuck are you doing?
Yeah.
And then I turn around and his brother is already charging me, going to punch me, and then fucking socks me in the face. I have to fight him for like 5-10 minutes.
Was it one-on-one or did they dogpile you?
No, it was one-on-one. Okay, so
that's respectable.
It was.
You can't jump in unless the fight is already swinging one way. Like, if your boy's losing, then push the other guy off, help your boy up. But you're not.
Yeah, no. I got thrown around. I got ground pounded. I only got one solid right cross to his head, and I cut his head with my knuckle. So it was one really good punch, but otherwise he fucked me up, just wailed on me.
I've been fucked up too, bro.
Throwing me around.
I've been fucked up before, bro.
It was on a little beach, because it was by this place called... I don't know if I should say this, Shore Drive in Salem. And it's off this little lake.
Mm-hmm.
So it had a little beachfront there. And it was just a little private one that was fenced in. So that's where we fought. So on the sand, I couldn't do shit to this dude that's bigger.
Of course. You know what I mean? You can't really jump or anything.
You can't do anything. You try to like put your feet down to get a good stance.
And you sink.
You just slide. You sink. Yeah. So he was smart, dude. He set me up for failure and fucked me up. And then after, I was like... Like, this fucking bullshit. I was like, I was supposed to fight you. Like, I was being all fucking extra and shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, yeah, but this kid, he was like on top of me. And I've told this part of the story on the pod before. And he was just back and forth, back and forth, back mm-hmm. and forth on my face. And just stopped. He was like, you've had enough. And just got up. Let me go. And then him and his boys left. And then like 2 of my friends that were there was like, that was fucked up. I'm like, I hate you. I hate all of you.
Dude, that is cold, bro.
Yeah.
I can see your boys like passing every gas station. Like, yo, I'm going to stop in here and gas. And you're like, what the fuck, bro? We're going to go fight. He's like, nah, I think I'm going
to we were all like starting to walk there. And like, we all left out of this, like we were all meeting up at one dude's house and then walking down the street to the sand area, to the beach.
And they all stopped on the way.
And then like, half of them just kept stopping, then more stopped. And then when I got there, I was fucking squaring up with 10 dudes 4 feet taller than me. Like, fucking scary. And
it's crazy because when you get fucked up like that, bro, when you get that in that situation, all you feel is hot.
Yes.
Like, you just feel hot.
I was angry, dude. I was ready to fight all of them. I didn't give a fuck,
dude. Yeah, dude. That's how it feels. Like, you can get beat to shit, and you just feel hot from your fucking toes to your head. Emotionally, physically, it's just, like, hot is the best way to describe it. I get hot, bro. I get heated so hot, bro, that I just got to swing to cool my head, to cool my arm down with the wind, bro.
Right, yeah. No, sometimes you just
gotta... And I'm not a fighter.
I definitely was. Yeah, I was a huge fighter up until I was like 20-ish.
I wasn't a fighter, but I hung out with kids that were. And like, there were 3 brothers and they always fought with each other. So I'd always fight with them. And like, just through fighting with them, I feel like I got better at it. When I had to defend myself later on in life, I fucking could. Which, if you can't defend yourself, it's kind of a...
Yeah.
It's kind of tough.
I mean, it's shitty. Looking back at it, it was just... It wasn't like... Like, I went into every part of it wrong. So I didn't know that that was the wrong person until that fight happened.
Yeah.
So afterwards, I was putting everything together. Like, I wasn't even texting the right fucking person.
Yeah.
And that dude I still have problems with because I still want to fuck him up for smacking my girl's ass.
Like, it didn't get resolved at all.
Nothing worked out of it. I was like, this was a letdown on every possible level. Like,
I lost on every, but that's okay. Yeah. Like, life is, that's what it's
you
about.
You need to do those in life. Like, if that didn't happen to me, I'd still be that cocky motherfucker. Like, firing off at those dudes. Right. Like, well, I still was for a little while, but
I'm sure those dudes have a story. Like, remember that kid that came and fought all of us by himself? Like, we fucked him up.
But. Yeah, they were talking hella shit after. They didn't give a fuck, dude. They were like, yeah, pussy, come back for more, you fucking faggot. Like, they were going hard. Like,
yeah, I've been there, bro. I fucked people up and then you talk mad shit. Like,
the weird thing is, though, I became boys with the kid who fucked me up. Yeah. I fucking love that kid now. Yeah. Me and him, well, we're not close anymore because it's been years, but.
Right, that's how it goes.
No, we were like hella close after, and like we actually chopped it up about that shit and we're laughing about it. So I was like, fucking, this is life, man. This is how it works.
That's pretty dope. I like how that ended. Yeah. Better than my story.
It's wholesome.
My story, just everyone got involved. It didn't go anywhere.
Yeah.
My mom's like, please don't fucking kill him.
Yeah.
And I was like, Mom.
So.
He made me really angry. She's like, I get it.
I have another story that.
I'm glad I didn't.
I don't think I can say, but should I just tell you real quick and then cut it out?
No, well, you have to cut it out?
Yes.
Then you can tell me later.
Okay.
It's all good. We can move on.
Yeah, that went off to an interesting topic. That was a...
Started off like... And that's because of that intro song, the Mona Lisa.
Yeah.
Dude.
That is because of that
getting
song.
Getting set up is aggressive.
Yeah.
But...
All right. What is a movie that you've watched... in your 20s, say, that when you watched when you were a kid, you thought was amazing, but it sucked ass when you rewatched it.
Okay, I'm not going to say suck ass, but I was disappointed.
Yeah.
I really liked the Emperor's New Groove growing up, like the guy that gets turns into a llama and shit.
Yeah.
That movie is fucking awesome. I watched it like a couple years ago with my ex, and it's still good, but it's really short.
It's okay.
It's like an hour long.
I watched that recently.
Yeah.
With Haley and Jake, actually.
It's not long at all.
It's like an hour and 20 minutes, dude. Yeah. It's hella short.
It's really short. Like, when it was over, I'm like, that's it?
Yeah.
I was like, that was the whole movie? Like, as a kid, I felt like it was really long.
Yeah. Man. No, it felt... I feel like even when we were kids, that probably was the case for all movies. If anything was past an hour, we were just like really fucking into it. We were really... Yeah. I don't know. Like now, like we're watching a movie. We're going on our phone during the movie. We're fucking...
Mm.
Mao and food, it's a little different.
Yeah,
I
right.
Feel like I don't know.
It is different, man. It is different. I will tell you this moment that I had literally last night, and I was thinking about it. Last night I had eaten dinner. It was like 9 p.m. and I got a little munchy because you know I smoke a little bit of weed, and I'm like, fuck, I got some bread and cheese in the fridge, so I got a little bit of bread and cheese, like French baguette, like nice bread, nice cheese.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like
I was gonna provolone. Ask, like, please tell me you didn't just throw American cheese on white bread.
No. It was good bread, good cheese.
Okay.
And then I was like, ooh, I got some grapes. I'll grab some grapes.
Okay.
So I grabbed some grapes, put on my plate, and then I had little salted, smoked, cured meats, like little sausages. So I'm like, oh fuck, I'll grab some of those. And when I sat down, I was like, I'm eating like a king right now. It's like 10 p.m. I'm eating smoked meats, fresh fruit, bread and cheese. Like all I'm missing is a glass of wine. I'm like, bro, like if this were 300 years ago, I'd be a king. Like,
yeah, 100%.
You know, I peasants don't eat like this, bro.
Right.
And I laughed at myself because I'm like, I'm doing pretty all right.
Yeah.
I'm doing pretty all right, you know?
So, yeah, no, I actually agree with that. I do have something to say about that, but I want to dive back for a second. Did you know David Spade was the voice of the llama in Emperor's New Groove, the main character? I didn't know that.
David Spade? Like, of the character, right? Not just the llama, of the whole character.
Yeah, the whole character. Yeah, yeah. No, I didn't know that until I rewatched it, like, with Haley and Jake. I was like, oh, fuck, that's David Spade.
Yeah.
It was cool, but we should go back to that conversation, too, about movies. I have a few good ones, but for this, I feel like I almost contribute that to my drinking sometimes, because every night, dude, I cook... fat meals, you know? I cook fucking feasts for myself and I'm alone.
Yeah.
And then I'd pour a glass of whiskey and it's the perfect fucking
meal. You just love it, bro.
It's perfect. Yeah. Half the time I wouldn't even get drunk, but again, it's just keeping up with that consistency I feel like was rough.
Yeah, right.
It is weird, but...
A glass of whiskey with dinner every night.
Yeah.
I feel you.
It starts to
get... I mean, we live in a really interesting time.
Right.
And it's like, you got homeless people. I drive by them every day. I'm only 25.
Yeah.
I'm doing all right. Wild. We're doing all right.
Yeah. I think we're doing good for our age.
I mean, it's really easy to be like, damn, I could be doing more. I always have that thought, damn, I could be doing more. And I'm doing a lot right now. Like, I'm not. And it's even still.
There's
always more to do.
We kind of like sabotaged ourselves in that way because I think the exact same shit. I'm always like, damn, I just feel like I'm doing nothing. I'm sitting around. I play too many video games. I fucking I drink too much. You know, like just shit. Obviously, that was... a part of everything, but now it's more like I feel like we work full-time jobs That's enough by itself. We work 40-hour weeks.
It is.
You know what I mean?
It isn't. All right.
Most people in America can say they can do that, but there's like a good 40 million that don't even do that, dude.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
If you have a full-time job, you're already doing more than a lot of people. I agree.
I know what you're going to say.
I'm just like... You got to hold yourself to a standard, man, you know? I can't just be satisfied with just working full-time. I got to be doing a lesson on the side. I got to be doing this fucking podcast on the side.
Right,
I got to
right.
be, you know, working on a project at home. I got to – so I feel you.
I think I was going to say you and me specifically are definitely like that because I feel like I still need to do more and I'm doing the music shit,
you
the
do
podcast
a lot.
Shit, the work shit. And then
you know what you need, and me too, but you need someone else to tell you that you're doing enough.
Exactly.
You need someone else to be like, bro, you're doing pretty good.
Yeah,
like,
honestly.
Don't worry.
I think when I had a girlfriend, actually, that's pretty much what a lot of it, like, because I'd spend a lot of the time where I'm not doing shit now with them doing shit.
Right.
So now it's like, fuck, I need to fill this empty space. What the fuck do I do? Like,
well, it's still surprising to me that I only knew you while you were single, but right before we started hanging out, you had a girlfriend. I still can't imagine.
Yeah, since I was like 10, dude. I've been in a relationship for my entire life.
This is strange, but
yeah.
You want to go back to the movie thing?
Yes.
What about the movie thing?
I think Star Wars were huge for me. I watched those when I was younger and thought they were cool.
I never saw them as a kid.
Really?
Any of them.
I thought they were cool when I was younger. I didn't think there were anything amazing. I didn't know what the hype was. But when I watched them when I was older, dude, I'm not a fan of them. I don't like those movies. Yeah.
They're really good.
I like the storylines, but I just – they're – it's drawn out for me.
Yeah.
It's a bit – I don't know. I'm not that intrigued in it for some reason.
In 2017 to 2018, I watched all of them. And I like them.
Yeah.
I thought that they – because you also have to take into account that the time that they were made in, like they're not
of
made
course.
Big production 70s, nowadays.
80s, like
– right, yeah. right. It was a while ago.
Long
they were
fucking
really
time
limited.
Ago.
So the assets that they had, I think they made a great movie.
And that,
so
I agree with that.
I feel you though.
And I think the storyline's great, which sucks to me that those movies aren't better.
Well, you know what it is too? It's like at the time, there was no movie like that.
At
that
all.
Was the only one of its – caliber at its time.
Right.
Nowadays, I can name 20 movies that are like fucking Star Wars.
I actually think that when Lord of the Rings came out in like 2000, I thought that was 10 times better than fucking Star Wars in every way.
A
I don't know why.
Yeah. A lot of people would
Harry Potter's, I thought they were 10 times better just in that kind of world.
They were okay.
I still thought they were a lot better, but
my ex forced me to watch all the Harry Potter movies.
Yeah,
and
you
I
said
just,
it drove you to the ground, right?
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. It was a bit much.
It was a lot. I didn't really like them.
Do you have
other
movies that come to your mind? Love when you were younger, you might have rewatched. I have another one, but I think I kind of expected.
Oh, well, I've seen Scott Pilgrim versus the World like a million times.
Okay.
I love that movie. I'll rewatch it. I think I might even rewatch it today and I'll still be like, that movie's awesome.
Yeah.
So good. Great track, great movie. A lot of fun. I like fun movies. I like fun things, light things.
Oh, okay. But you're saying so you still like the movie and you liked it when you first watched it. Okay. I thought you were going to be like, I don't know if I like it anymore.
No,
the
it's
end
a great
of the,
fucking movie,
no,
bro.
No, it's a good movie.
Stellar.
Goonies. That was another one for
me. Maybe the Rugrats Go to London. I don't know, some shit like that.
Yeah, probably.
Do you remember that one?
No, I didn't. I wasn't a big cartoon kid.
No?
No.
It was like the orange cassette tape, the Rugrats, bro?
I did actually watch that. Well, I remember the cassette tape.
yeah, the cassette tape is iconic, bro.
Yeah, I remember the cassette tape. I probably watched it. I don't know. But I wasn't that huge into like SpongeBob and shit like that. And all those
no
movies.
Way.
I swear
SpongeBob
to God.
Was fucking awesome.
Yeah, no. I was more into like
so good.
Courage the Cowardly Dog, Bugs Bunny, and then real shows. I liked mindless shit.
Courage the Cowardly Dog, bro.
That scared the fuck out of me.
That show gave me anxiety.
Yeah, dude.
Kid, bro.
I was fucking sweating watching that show.
Bro, I would watch that show from behind the couch.
Yeah.
Because like when the shit came on that I didn't like, I just stopped watching because I'm like, this is too much.
Yeah. I don't know if I'd hide, but I know what you mean.
Yeah, I'd hide. The show was...
Did you fuck with scary shit when you were a kid?
I don't like scary shit, period. Like, I don't think any of it's good.
But I mean, like, when you were real young, did it, like, scare you, actually?
Yeah, it scared me big time.
I think there was some of them that did, but there was a threshold that they just got dumb.
Mm-hmm.
And then I didn't care anymore.
Yeah, I feel like they're all pretty dumb.
Yeah.
My ex was really into scary movies, and unfortunately, I watched a million. I'm of the opinion right now that like they're just not that good.
Yeah. I think a lot of girls like scary movies. Most women I meet like
scary movies. They're good date movies.
That's a good point.
She gets scared. She pulls you a little closer.
Yeah, grabs your dick.
Yeah. Yeah. She grabs your dick.
You grab hers, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. Jack each other off in the movie. It's just something we've done it a million times. A
million times. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. All right. If a girl wanted to eat your ass on the first date, would you let her?
Oh, God. On the first date?
Yes.
Oh, God.
I felt weird.
How insistent is she, like, really, like, I want to do it, like, really, like, please,
no,
please,
no, let's please. Say she throws it out there, but you could tell she was serious, but it, like, kind of threw you off.
I've
had this happen to me.
I'd pick up on the fact that she was serious, so I'd be like, what do you mean by that? I'm like, for real?
Would you question it on a first date?
Yeah, I'd be like, do you really? And she'd be like, yeah, I'd like that. I wouldn't be ready for her to eat my ass on the first. I'd have to shave it.
Okay. Yeah, you got to prepare, right?
Yeah, I'd have to prepare, bro.
I couldn't ever let that happen.
Buy myself a fucking a anal douche.
Yeah.
Dude, I wouldn't let her go down there normally.
I still couldn't imagine myself ever having my ass eaten, but I have had this asked to me before, mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. It wasn't a restaurant. It was a bar, and the conversation was literally like we were talking about normal shit, vibing, having a great conversation. And out of nowhere, dude, she's like, yeah, you know, keep up with that. And I'll have to take you back to your place and eat your ass later. And I was like, okay. Like, I didn't know what to do.
Did you let her?
No, dude, I didn't go home with her. It scared the fuck out of me. Stopped the whole shit for me.
No way.
I swear to God. Yeah.
Man.
Dude, it came out of nowhere. Like, it wasn't even a sexual conversation.
I'm going to have to take you home and eat your ass.
Yeah.
Wow.
Have you ever, like, bro.
I've never even told a girl that.
Yeah.
No, I have, probably.
But it's probably a girl you know, right? A girl you've
a girl that I've been flirting with for a couple days.
No, dude, first fucking time. Maybe she was drunk. I don't know, now that I look back at it, but.
Probably.
She could have been. She could have been. Yeah.
You know, listen, girls, if you got a man, you gotta treat him right. Eat his ass.
Yeah.
If he's a king, eat his ass.
Ask him if you want to.
Don't even ask. Next time you're blowing him, it's a night, blow him, you know, tell him to lay back. All right. Listen, this is how it is. Listen, ladies, I'm going to give you advice. No woman listen to this, but I'm going to give you some advice.
All right? Yeah, that's a fact.
This is what's going to happen. All right. And no woman are listening to this, but he's sitting on the edge of the bed, on the couch or whatever. She's blowing him from the ground.
Yeah.
All right. And she's like, all right, lay back. She's like, lay back. And he's like, all right, I'll lay back. Because like, as a guy, when you get in head, like you put your hands behind you, you kind of like sit there and kind of just like enjoy it. But she tells him, you got to tell him lay back.
You don't look at her? I look at him.
Sometimes.
No,
it depends. Like I don't like getting blown and just being right there and just looking. I kind of do, but like I'm saying lean back.
I get what you're saying. Yeah, okay.
You know, I'm not like right over her.
Yeah.
You know? But anyways.
That'd be so funny.
I tell him to lay back. He lays back. And then put your arms down underneath his legs. Keep on blowing him. Don't tell him anything. Put your arms down underneath his legs. Go under his thighs.
No. Get the fuck out of here.
Get your hands up the bed.
No.
Like under his knees, like around here, right? So, and then don't touch him because you don't want him to know. Like you're going to surprise him. And then lift his knees over him. And he's going to be like this. He's going to be like changing a baby's diaper. And then go. And girls, he's going to marry you.
No.
He's going to marry you. He's going to wipe that shit. The next day, he's going to propose. I'm telling you.
Okay.
He's going to propose.
There is actually, like, I want to say most guys will probably enjoy that.
Eat his ass. No, not
if
most
a girl
guys. Not most
ever
guys.
Even considers doing that to me, I'll shit on her.
You won't.
Yeah.
You won't.
I'll do something fucked up, dude.
No, you won't.
Yes,
no,
I will.
Won't.
I will do
you
something fucked up.
You kick her before you shit on her. You
okay,
kick
maybe,
her in the head.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe.
But what the and then you knock her ass out and be like,
no, I thought you
shit.
Meant out of instinct. I didn't know. I'm not going to purposely like boot her in the fucking.
Yeah, you will.
Nah, dude. If anything.
Yeah, you will.
Okay, say the second.
Come on, John.
If a girl.
You kick her in the jaw.
If it's a girl that's blowing me and she tells me to lay back on the bed, right?
You're just going to do it, first of all.
I'm going to do it. Yes. No questions asked. How, you're which like, sucks yeah, in I'll this scenario. No.
You'll go like this.
Yeah.
You're like, hell yeah.
Because I'm already set back. Up for failure. Yeah. You know? It's yeah. like, that's the opportunity there.
Yeah.
The second...
is she, you're like, dude, what the fuck?
Dude, if she just goes like this, I'm stomping down as hard as I fucking can and squeezing. And I'm going to be like, don't fucking do that. I swear to God.
No, you're not.
I swear
dude.
To God.
No, you're not.
I
no,
swear
not.
To God.
Listen, because this is what's going to happen. First of all, you're going to... When she tells you to lay down, you're like, yeah, I'm the fucking guy, because you feel like a boss.
Yeah, the
head.
Mood, dude. I'll go soft. Like,
no. Listen, you're not, bro. I'm telling you what's gonna happen. You're gonna be like, yeah, I'm getting head right now. You lay back, and she's gonna lift your legs, and the first thing you're gonna feel is her hands behind your knees, purposefully pushing you.
Yeah,
you're gonna be pushed back, and you're not gonna have much more. Like, there's. If she does it properly and she holds your knees like to your chest, you're not gonna have the force to push her back down.
No,
she's gonna have you there. She's gonna have you, and then she's gonna be in your ass. She'll put in your asshole, bro. Right? And then when that's happening, you're gonna be so surprised, bro. You're gonna be like, first of all, I'm in this position. My asshole is wet. My dick is hard. And I'm like, and then you know what happens?
No.
And then you come.
No, that's not gonna happen. None of this is going to happen like this.
And then you come, and then you nut, and you, since you're laying back, it goes all over your chest. You're like, fuck.
Oh,
shit.
God.
Oh, and you're just coming all over yourself.
No.
Bro. And
no.
Then she's gonna let go when you're done, and you're gonna be covered in splooge. You're gonna be like,
has this happened to you?
No, but
this is very specific.
This is really specific. This is great.
No, it's not.
This is great. And
I can't imagine.
Then you're gonna go to. She's gonna tuck you in and covered in splooge. She's gonna tuck you in. And gonna
tuck you in.
She's gonna be like, "I'm gonna go watch some TV." And you're like, "Okay."
You're like, "Thanks, mommy.
Thanks. No. Thank you." Okay.
Yeah. No, dude, that's too much for me. Do your balls just sit on her forehead if she's eating your ass?
Probably. Yeah.
Right. They sit on her nose.
Yeah, like in on her eyes, because her mouth is here, right? And the balls are gonna be like right here.
Oh, man.
Each on her eyeballs.
I would feel so violated, dude. I couldn't picture the.
That's why I take a nap.
See, the hands and the knees, that's enough for me where I'd freak. I wouldn't be able to do it.
We should tell Haley to do this, even, Jake.
Okay, we should. I'm down
this
for this.
This would be hilarious,
yes,
bro.
Yeah.
And then just have audio recording from the other room.
Oh, no.
Because I want to hear it. Just going to go, what the fuck?
100%. Yeah.
He's going to freak out.
I think Jake's in the same boat as me. Like, no one can go near my ass. Nothing. Doctors can have to fight for it. Never mind fucking girlfriends. You know
I think
I mean?
You'd be surprised.
I think
Jake would sit there and be like, I think all you'd hear from the other room is, oh, yeah. Oh, fuck.
I don't think now. Jake would
freak
out.
Bro.
I don't know.
I think so, bro.
Should we call
I'm
him?
I'm telling you.
On the pod.
Should we call him?
Yo, bro.
Is he free?
Haley ate your ass.
We can ask him.
I mean, I can't put it on speakerphone. You can call from your phone.
What do you mean?
Oh, my phone doesn't work.
Do you want
speakerphone.
It?
We could. I don't
Let's
know.
Let's go for it. If
Do
it
you
doesn't
think
work
he'll
out,
answer?
Yeah. If it doesn't work out, he. What's his phone number? You think he's gonna pick up? He doesn't have my phone number.
Oh, probably not. We'll see. You
we'll
put
see.
It on the mic. Let him know he's on the podcast too.
He's depending on what he's doing. He's probably not gonna pick up.
Yeah, he could be with Haley too. So.
Doesn't she work?
Yeah, I don't know if she's working out, though. She might work at, like, 3 or something.
You're right, you're right. He's getting his ass eat right now.
Your call has been forwarded
yeah.
to an automatic voice.
I'm going to leave him a message.
Yeah.
Hey, Jake, this is Ruben. I'm on the podcast with John right now.
What up?
Listen, man, this is an emergency, bro. We need you. Like, you're the only person that we could turn to right now. So when you get this message, give me a call back. Thanks, bro. That's an emergency, bro.
Okay, yeah, that
know.
Might work. That
I
might work. My eyes feel like there's cold air blowing on them now. Okay. No.
Oh, it must be the Mentos then, the mint.
Maybe, yeah.
Okay.
No girl better ever even try to eat my ass. Get
if,
the fuck out
if
of here.
If any woman have boyfriends that listen to this, and nobody does, but if you do,
yeah.
do this to your boyfriend. Let us know how it
you
turns
know,
out.
I was gonna say let's set this up for the audience listeners
yeah.
because we don't do enough shit like that.
Yeah,
if you've eaten your boyfriend's ass. And he enjoys it.
Yeah.
For one, let us know. Either comment on YouTube.
Yeah.
Call or text 603-922-4074. Email brootofyou@gmail.com.
Word.
Or try this. Let us know his reaction. You can even call into the pod. Leave us, you know, you can try to talk to us if you, That'd be pretty fire.
Yeah, that would be fire. Leave us a little story.
Yeah.
Tell us how it went.
Give them a call back during the pod.
If you got a video, even better.
A video would be a bit much, I think.
A video would be perfect.
I don't know if we could do that.
I think we both agree that would both be really, that would be really good.
Okay.
So if you get a video of eating your boyfriend's ass without his consent, let us know.
Okay.
Because we want to see.
Now.
I'm sure you could find that on online. You think that's a genre?
Sure.
Eating his ass unprompted?
Probably. It's porn. You know how many weird shit there is with porn, dude?
There's some weird shit.
I think you can look up almost anything sexual and it will come up.
I told you about the knife in the pussy last week, right?
You did, yes. It was a very painful first five minutes of the episode.
That still hurt me. That still bothers me.
Listening back to that and editing it was actually a bit difficult because of how gross that was.
It was really fucked up.
Really gross. Have you seen the video where the guy sticks the
jar?
No, I've seen that one.
That one's fucked.
Yeah. No, this one, he takes a marshmallow poker and sticks it in his urethra through his dick hole. We shouldn't be talking about this.
That's awful.
Yeah, especially on the pod.
Can we see? You think that YouTube will cut it out?
It's pretty safe to say YouTube will cut it out. Yeah.
I feel like it's pretty informational. Do you know YouTube has porn, has sex toy reviewing content?
Yes.
You did know that?
Yes.
A couple months ago, I heard about this and I had to look it up to see if it was true. And it's true. If you go on YouTube, you can see videos of girls inserting things into their vaginas.
Oh, I didn't know that was on YouTube.
Yes. And like being like, oh, this feels good. Like this toy is amazing. The vibration here is really good.
How is that on YouTube?
There's a video on YouTube, two gay guys. This is the one that got me hip to it because this was on Reddit. Two gay guys are reviewing sex. And you know what the title of the video is? I'll tell you, this is fucked. The title of the video is trying to find out. Trying to see if I can tell the difference between my boyfriend's dick and a dildo. And they do that. He's like, okay, who knows? Am I sticking my dick? So this guy's like on his hands and knees.
I don't believe. Wait, this is on YouTube.
This is on YouTube, bro. This guy's on his hands and knees. And then there's like a little tarp in the back and it's covering everything, and all you can see is another guy behind him and his head's up, and he's like, okay, which one am I sticking in right now? And he puts it in, he's like, oh, that's definitely your dick. He's like, yeah, it's my dick, you caught me. And it, like, they do that for like 30 minutes.
But does it show it?
No, that's the thing, they don't show it. Like, it's covered by a tarp, but you can see both the men.
Okay, I guess that's a loophole. Is that still porn, though?
It's definitely still porn. It's definitely still porn. They're like, look at this dildo. It looks like this, and it's like this, and it's shaped like this. Like, can you tell the difference if it's a dick or a dildo? And it was strange.
This is on YouTube?
This is on YouTube.
What the fuck? Yeah.
YouTube is weird, bro.
Wild,
YouTube is a weird place to be on.
Do you think they won't get rid of it because...
Well, technically, it's informational content. It's content.
That is not informational content. Testing if a dildo. It is. How is that informational?
I don't know.
It's not providing
anything for me, bro. Exactly. But I mean, for guys that like their dildos, or for girls that like their dildos.
But doesn't that only provide info for the other person in the video? Like, how does that do anything with the viewers? YouTube's a little dicey with that. Well,
YouTube is really dicey.
Have you seen the educational videos that I feel like I used to watch those when I was a kid?
Like learning videos on YouTube?
Yeah. Like where they show their tits and their vagina and shit like that.
What are you talking about?
So when I was younger and porn was a little harder to come by, there was videos on YouTube where it's like explaining the vagina and explaining like the breasts and everything. And they showed it because it is literally educational. And it's just a doctor with a glove on, like pulling the pussy lips apart and showing you like the hole and shit, and then showing the boobs, and that's on YouTube, which I thought was where you were going to go with this.
You got off to that?
No. I just, when I was a kid, I was like,
come on, John,
I need to see something. I mean, it's pretty hard to get off to it if like a guy is just like talking
in a sterile environment.
Yeah. And he's talking like, and this is where, like, I don't know. It does not really.
This is the lobby.
Yeah. It's not really a turn on.
No, I agree.
Yeah.
What's the least sexual thing you've nutted to?
Girls dancing.
That's it?
Probably. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I mean, give me an example of what.
So like when I was a kid, I had really bad internet, and I was visiting my grandma for a week. Mm-hmm. And I had, like, entertainment. I don't even remember if it was a phone or, like, a video game thing. I don't remember. But I would look up nudies on there, and they never loaded because I was using the neighbor's Wi-Fi to only work from, like, the corner of the bathroom. If I got on a stool and put my thing right in the corner,
okay,
it would take, like, 10 minutes to load a picture.
Okay, I remember that stuff.
It was brutal. Yep.
Yeah, so and one, it does, like, one piece of the picture at a time.
Exactly. Yep, it's like, yep, when you get titty, you got, like, half a titty.
Right, so, you're like, oh, here we go.
Here we go. Like, it's getting crazy. So, like, this one time, I was really trying to get off, and I wasn't getting any service. And I was like, I'll get off to anything. Like, it was savage. And I found this really blurry photo, really shaded out pair of boobs. Like, I couldn't – maybe they were boobs. Maybe. They were circular and they had dots on them. That's all I know. And I got off to them.
Wow. Okay.
And that's all I needed.
Just, like, objects.
That's
basically
all I couldn't tell if they were boobies. Like, I definitely looked up titties, but I couldn't tell. Because they were, it was such a bad quality
okay
photo.
I feel like there is something that I've...
You know what I mean?
Yes.
That was awful. And then afterward, and I was a kid. I was like 14, 15.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh man, this is
okay
nothing. Like, this is probably not even a pair of tits.
I know.
This is probably like two lights.
What if I feel like I have something similar to that I've jerked ridiculous off to, bro, that I cannot think of now.
When you're a kid, you just fucking...
Right, right.
It doesn't even matter, bro. It don't even matter, son.
Have you heard of people like jerking off to like when a tree has like a certain shape and like the line?
I have,
yeah,
dude.
I feel like it was something like that I just can't think of now.
You know, you thought about it. You're like, that's pretty weird. I'm gonna keep it to myself.
No, because when I think about it, when I was younger, there it was animated shit. That's what got me. I was like, oh fuck, like
you liked anime. You like animated stuff when you
Betty
were a kid?
Boop, no. Jessica Rabbit, that
oh,
bitch.
Oh, yeah, but dude, that stuff was so overly sexualized.
100%, dude. Fat
like
titties,
Jessica
fat
Rabbit
ass
had this pair of hips on her.
And the tits, dude. They were like, her body
hanging
was
out
like this, and the
yeah
tits would come out to here.
Yeah,
it didn't
bro
make any sense, but I loved it. I was obsessed. Like,
who framed Roger Rabbit?
Facts,
crazy
facts.
Crazy sexualized. Betty Boop Boop, crazy
Betty
sexualized.
Boop, boop. But that's where I go back.
I
I'm like, that was
I
probably
agree
the least sexual, but I don't know if that's even that is kind of considered sexual. So,
yeah, I
in,
think
in
so
a way, you know, like,
I think many a child has busted a nut to Lola Bunny.
Yeah,
which is why they removed all that sexual stuff from her
oh
in
yeah
the new movie,
which they definitely should. I feel like that's pretty aggressive.
Yeah,
looking back at a lot of that shit, dude, I was like, wow. Even the jokes in some of these cartoons were like really dark and
mm-hmm
sexual and yeah.
Yeah, they really pepper them in.
Yeah.
Back in the days, they peppered them in
yeah
hard, bro.
Fucked up our parents.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Maybe some of us too, but mm-hmm I feel like we didn't, I don't know.
We didn't pick up on it, 100%.
Yeah.
100%, that went over our heads.
Now, with Hydrocell, staying hydrated doesn't have to break your bank. A 64-ounce bottle like this, under $30. Use our link in the description. Get yourself one today. Stay hydrated, you goddamn fool. Get yourself a 420 cleaner today. Under $20. Please, all your pieces, acrylic, glass, doesn't matter. Use our link in the description. You fool.
This episode is brought to you by Amazon Music. Amazon Music is one of the best exclusive music apps out right now. I actually use that because I have an Android, so I don't have Apple Music or anything, and the YouTube Music is kind of, it's hit or miss sometimes. Not all the music's on there. Google Play's kind of hit or miss too, but Amazon Music has everything. You use the code BROOT and you can get 3 months free now instead of just one. So if you go to getamazonmusic.com/BROOT, BROOT, you can get 3 months free of Amazon Music. Again, that's getamazonmusic.com/BROOT. Get 3 months free. Back to the episode.
Are we back?
We're good. Had to get an extra rinse out. Yeah, what'd you think about the queso, by the way? I said I made some damn good queso.
It was good. It was good queso. The flavor was there for sure.
I don't think that's the best I've ever made, to be honest. I think I've made a little bit better ones, but...
I think, realistically, all that it needed was a little bit of time on the stove.
Right.
To melt properly.
Definitely needed to melt a little longer. That's why I was fucking 10 minutes in that big-ass bowl. Still didn't fucking go all
yeah
the way through. I was like, Jesus
yeah
Christ.
Yeah, I needed to be on heat and
yeah
then stirring constantly. But even then, it'll burn. Have you ever made it with another kind of cheese, or you just use American?
I have. I've used a bunch of different ones.
Yeah, but American's the best.
White American with the peppers and onions and combination salsa verde, it's very good, I guess.
It is good.
The
it
other
good,
ones with those, they get a little bit too sweet on some of them. Some of them have a bit of a different flavor. Right. So this one's like a real gritty cheese. Mm-hmm. It's like a good cheese flavor. A little sweet, nice spice.
It was good. I liked it. It could have used a little bit of time on the stove.
Right.
It might have been, and I only say this because like it was a little bit gritty because it still wasn't melted perfectly, but excuse me. If it had like a binder, like a thicker cheese to kind of help it emulsify, maybe like a Munster. I don't know. But does it get creamy if you let it cook thoroughly?
Well, it gets really, really watery really fast. Okay. But I think I just used way too much cheese. I thought for some reason when I was filling that bowl up, I wasn't using that much cheese. But
yeah.
I used over a pound. And then I looked at it afterwards. I was like, oh, fuck. I used all the cheese.
Did you buy a block of American cheese?
I don't like
slices.
Yeah, no, I get the slices. I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah. But
interesting. No, it was good queso.
Yeah. I talk about it a lot off mic, but yes, I always try to show mad people the queso I make, and I feel like next time I'll try to do a much smaller batch.
Yeah.
Melt that shit through.
Yeah, maybe fucking maybe get some more people here to help us out for
Dude,
sure.
I normally cook queso 2 minutes with a minute 30 afterwards with the stirs, and it's fine. That was 10 minutes and it's still not melted all the way through.
Yeah,
I was like, okay, this is fucking bad, but
yeah, it was rough.
It was still had the flavors. It was still, he got the idea. You know what I mean? He got the fucking gist of it.
No, I liked it, bro.
Yeah.
It
is there something you cook that you are like fond of that you consider like a signature thing you cook?
Oh, yeah. I made a signature. I want to say it's like a signature sandwich because I drew inspiration from places and I made it. But I make a really bomb turkey burger. Basically, I get ground turkey. I spice it up and then I let it sit so all the moisture comes out. I let the moisture drip. And then I emulsify butter into it, spiced butter. That's usually what I'll do. I'll actually spice the butter and then I'll mix it into the meat. And then when I cook it, it'll have little butter chunks and it'll be really juicy like a beef patty. Like a hamburger.
Okay.
It's fucking mega juicy, even though it's a turkey burger.
Okay.
That's why I add the butter to add fat back into it. That's pretty standard. That's one of my go-tos. I make bomb chicken parm, but I mean, you don't really have a special recipe for that. It's just chicken parm.
Yeah.
It's a shame
but
of shit.
I've had some really shitty ones though, so that is like
I have to.
Right. To get it to get it perfectly right. Do you I'm guessing you bread it and everything? You do all that shit or
Yeah. Okay. By the breast. Fillet it, you butterfly it, smash it,
right,
and then you you know, then you serve it.
Yeah, we don't have to do that deep dive, but say you were going to a party of 30 people.
Okay.
Two things you're bringing. You should bring kind of like an entree type of thing, and then like an appetizer type of thing.
If I'm bringing two things and it's a party, that's tough. That's tough. I'll probably go with riblets. Have you ever had riblets? So you get these little beef ribs that are sliced. They're not like big ribs. Because I feel like beef ribs, when they're big like that, they're kind of like, they're good, but they're just too much.
They could be much.
They could be a lot.
Yeah.
Like a lot of fat.
Right.
Not enough meat.
Right.
Like really thin, really overcooked. I've had a lot of beef ribs and a lot of them are really bad. But like riblet cuts that it's like the whole rib cage, but they slice it horizontally so they're a little piece of the bone in every piece.
I have had that.
And they're thin.
Yes.
And then you marinate them overnight with garlic and soy. And then you cook them on the grill the next day with a little bit of honey and bro. They're so fucking good.
Yeah.
They're so juicy, bro.
I had that at the Italian festival in Lawrence.
Oh, dude, how was that?
Amazing.
Amazing.
I would need to go back to there. I haven't been there in like 8 years.
Yeah, I haven't been there in a while either.
Yeah.
Weird, Italian festivals in Lawrence. But anyways.
Yeah, I always thought that was a bit I was like.
Well, it's originally an Italian city.
Exactly.
It was an immigrant city.
But I was going to say, you know, like there was big beefs between white Italians and yes,
Hispanics.
So
yeah, back in the
it's strange that those 70s, still go 80s. On and it's mostly Hispanics that go there now. Mm-hmm. But I'm kind of glad. Mm-hmm. I'm glad it's not like a very hostile thing. So I guess it can be. I don't know. But
yeah, it's not. Lawrence isn't the way it used to be.
Right.
Like even when I was in high school, it's pretty. I mean, there are still aggressive places in Lawrence and aggressive people. But
at night, it's really bad.
No.
I heard now at night. I don't know if that's true, but yeah.
No. It straightened up pretty hard.
Okay.
The police presence is really intense down there.
Yeah.
But again, if you go, dude, if you go to the ghetto areas looking for ghetto people and ghetto things, you're going to find ghetto people and ghetto things.
Of course.
Like, that's the thing that pisses me off about stereotypes. I tell people about, you know, the fact that I grew up in Lawrence. They go, oh, so you're like, you grew up thugging. Like, kind of.
Yeah.
And I did. Don't get me wrong. But yeah, it's not all of it.
It immediately puts a profile in people's head.
Yeah. I've said this, but I lie about where I'm from. Yeah. If people ask me where I'm from, I go, yeah, I grew up in Boston.
Yeah.
I grew up in Andover. I don't tell them I grew up in Lawrence because it's just easier not to.
Right.
You know?
Right.
It's real shit.
I did completely cut you off, so... Perfect riblets. Did you have another one? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to go down the tangent.
No, riblets. And then I make a pretty bomb potato salad, so I might make that.
That's a good choice.
I make a really good potato salad.
I was thinking for me, it would just be a big old tub of queso.
Okay.
Probably made on the stove. I don't think I'd make that one in the microwave. I'd take it serious. So I do like not spicy batch and then a spicy batch, you know?
Okay, okay. Like a little bit for everybody.
Right.
Yep.
And then I would do a big ass tub of pulled pork. I make a mean fucking pulled pork. I'd cook it in a crock pot.
I'm not a fan of pulled pork, bro.
Over 8 hours. I'm just thinking something that would be filling enough for 30 people because queso can kind of weigh a party down at times. Do you know what I mean?
And pulled pork and queso combo, I mean, that's a combo.
It's a combo. It's a bit much. So I'm thinking, wow, what can I do? I was thinking pigs in a blanket. That's wicked cheesy, though.
It's not that bad. I like pigs in a blanket.
You know what I mean? The other stuff I cook that's good is like meat. Like, I cook good-ass steak. I cook
yeah,
good, you know what I
right.
mean?
So like, you're marinating something nice and making it real nice. Now, dude, I was going to say something. Fuck. Oh. Pulled pork.
Yeah.
Not a fan of it.
Not a fan.
Let me tell you why.
Okay.
Pork is one of my favorite cuts of meat.
What? And you don't like pulled pork?
Hear me out.
I'm getting starstruck.
I love pork anything. If I go to a place and they have a menu and the menu says fatty cut of pork, bro, I am in. I love pork skins. I love it. Pork is one of my favorite meats. All right. Pulled pork is when they render it down and they reduce all the fat from the pork.
Yeah.
And it's just stringy meat. And they sauce that motherfucker with copious amount of barbecue.
Okay. So you've had some shitty pulled porks.
At that point, you have a rendered down stringy pork that has pork flavor, but no pork fat, no pork skin. And then you have it's just shitty pork with barbecue. Yeah. And it's like
– can I tell you what I do?
What the I swear – bro –
can you hear me out on mine?
I'll cap on you.
Hear me out on mine, right?
If you come out with me with some pulled pork shit, I'll cap on you, bro. But go.
Next time you show up, I just have it. You're like, motherfucker, I told you. Like,
we're beefing. Let's go.
All right. Listen to me. Let's just hear out this and think of it and then be like, okay, maybe, right?
Okay. I'm all ears.
Pork butt.
I'm listening.
Giant thing of pork butt.
Yes, I like it so far.
You slow roast it for a good 4 to 6 hours.
Pork butt is just pork shoulder, by the way.
Exactly. Yeah. I wanted to say pork shoulder, but everyone knows it as pork butt. So, so after that time with the slow cooking, it falls apart.
Yep.
Like butter almost. 100%. So you just take all that shredded pork.
Yep.
Throw it in a crock pot.
Yep.
Put a very tiny amount of barbecue sauce and let it marinate for the first 4 hours. Mm-hmm. For the next 4 hours, put another very tiny amount, let it go for another 4 hours. After that full 8 hour, technically 12 hour cook, it is the tastiest fucking pork I've ever eaten. Swear to God. Barely any barbecue sauce, dude. You can put more on at the end if you want it. And then I always slap cheese on there too. It's fucking fire. I don't know how that doesn't sound. It sounds like you've just had gross-ass pork mixed with a shit ton of barbecue sauce.
That's exactly what I've had.
So that's not what pulled pork sandwiches are. That's not.
But that is exactly. No, it isn't. I have been to upscale restaurants, and I've eaten the good pulled pork.
But that's the issue. Don't do it at a restaurant. Try it. Try someone making it homemade. I promise you.
Listen, man, if you're rendering out a pork shoulder, all right, and then you're stringing it, and then you add barbecue to it, like –
what do you mean?
All you, bro.
Dude, it's going to be dry as fuck.
You know what I would
fuck.
Do? No.
Yes.
No.
Listen. Yes. The juices are not enough. I promise you.
You got a red onion. You got a green pepper. You got garlic. You got oregano.
Now, yeah.
You put that in a blender.
That's not pulled pork at that
You put
point.
That in a blender. You emulsify it. You put that in a pan. You sweat it. So it all cooks out on its own.
No.
Then you add the pork. After you slow cooked it, and then you add the pork in there, you mix it up, you got delicious carnitas, bro.
Yeah.
You got carnitas for days.
Right.
You're going to tell me you got to put some bitch-ass, fucking pussy-ass, fucking bitch pussy ass barbecue sauce in that, bro? No.
Little sweet dude. Baby Rays?
No. No. Dude.
All right, we have to agree to disagree.
No, I'm not even agreeing to disagree.
I'm accepting
you're
the
wrong,
fact
bro.
That you haven't had good pulled pork, and
no,
that's it.
I've
that's
had
the end
good
of it.
Pulled pork.
Nope,
that
that's
shit
the end
sucks.
Of it. Yeah.
It's
that's
trash.
The end of it, unfortunately.
Listen, man, if you're taking this fatty, juicy, tender
now,
skin.
But you're turning it into
oh
other
my God,
food.
And then you add fucking barbecue and string it out and render out the fat. You're fucking.
Okay,
I don't know what you
well,
are.
I don't, you're making it sound like someone dumping more barbecue sauce than pork in there. Bro, you barely put a cup in there. It's not even a full cup.
That's too much.
You barely put a quarter of
much.
A fucking
it's
cup.
Too much. It's too much. So you don't put any, bro. You
yeah,
gotta let
you
the pork.
No,
you gotta let the
you
pork
had
sing.
You we'll
put
agree
salt,
to disagree.
Pepper, onions, you know, garlic,
yeah,
oregano.
See, you're turning it into something else.
Maybe a little bit of thyme, a
no
little
way.
Bit of a bay leaf
that
in there.
That actually sounds really good.
Oh, my God, then we're talking carnitas, and then you take that out.
I love
the crock pot,
carnitas, yeah.
And then you put that on a griddle, a sizzling hot cast iron, and let that motherfucker get crispy on both sides, and you throw that motherfucker.
Dude, someone was telling me that they had they had pulled pork empanadas. I was like, what?
Yeah.
Pulled pork empanadas?
That sounds fucking good.
Sounds amazing, right?
That sounds awesome, bro.
I don't know
how
that would.
It's not pulled pork. It's carnitas.
It's just carnitas. Exactly.
Carnitas.
Yeah. People don't
really
know what the word
is. You're
not
going to catch a Mexican making. Dude, if I catch a Mexican putting barbecue in my pork, we're fucking.
Wait, hold on.
Fighting.
What if it's the exact same thing I said, but not barbecue sauce? What if I put a different type of sauce in it?
What sauce? What kind of sauce?
Anything. What do you like?
All right. Let me tell you what would work in that scenario.
Chipotle mayo.
If you did a sugar based heavy glaze, like a bourbon glaze.
You are a hypocrite.
And you let that motherfucker, but just a like.
That's the same shit as barbecue sauce, bro. That's the same fucking shit.
Barbecue sauce is ketchup, Worcestershire, soy, sugar.
Right.
That's barbecue.
Right.
That's bullshit.
Dude, the bourbon
sauce.
Bourbon glaze.
Bourbon glaze
is a
made
cousin.
From alcohol.
That's
it's
a cousin for barbecue.
They render out bourbon.
They're almost the same.
It's a sauce.
They're almost the same. Come
no,
on. Come
none,
on.
It's not even,
come on.
Not even made from the same
they're
shit.
They're not the same shit
no,
at all.
Bro.
It's just that you got to admit
listen,
they're
bro,
very
sauces
similar.
Sauces are not made equal, bro. Bro, this is... bro, I'm getting so... bro, you're not going to tell me. You're not going to fucking tell me,
it
bro.
Sucks because we both love cooking, so we're both very passionate about it. We're like,
dude,
fuck, man!
Dude, if you're adding ketchup... And
I guess wow,
barbecue is brown sugar, ketchup, soy sauce, garlic, Worcestershire. The fuck out of here!
So you
put that shit in pork.
You
are
like a pulled
me?
Pork sandwich if it just was a bourbon glaze instead of barbecue sauce.
If it, okay, but not just a bourbon glaze. And when I say a bourbon glaze, you gotta let the pork get crispy. You know, that motherfucker crispy dog, and they put the
what? You're
the
letting
top.
It get crispy? That's not pulled pork then. That ain't the shit, man.
Well, when you put on the gravy,
little sloppy Joe I'm looking
see,
for.
See, like, what I don't want is I don't want the bourbon glaze mixed in with the pork. That's not what I want. I want the pork to be
right.
Salty.
You want it to
I want
have
the pork
a, I
to
get
be
what you're saying.
Juicy.
Yeah.
I want it to be not a fucking soup.
Yeah,
I hate it when a motherfucker shows up to the pot like with a fucking soup and I say, what's the soup? And they go, it's fucking pulled pork. Get the fuck out of here. Go home, bro.
Wait, people
go
do
home,
that?
Bro.
That's not considered soup.
Bro, if
that's
you show up, no, but the crock pot
right,
is full
right,
of
right.
liquid, and the liquid is liquidy. It's not viscous. It's thin liquid, and it's going left to right. They're walking around with it, and the liquid's going,
yeah,
like,
that,
that smells
gross.
Good. That looks good. They open it up, and it's just like meat fibers at the bottom with
okay,
no,
bro. You are
no,
explaining.
Bro.
I know what you've had
that
now.
That sucks,
I know what
dude.
You've had now. Okay.
That sucks, dude.
Yeah, you haven't had pulled pork then.
No, pulled pork
you
sucks. Barbecue
I'm sorry,
pork
you haven't.
Is not good,
we have
dude.
To get off this, but I'm sorry. You haven't, man. That's not what it is at all. On mine, you can't see the barbecue sauce. You literally can't see it. You can only taste the very
I don't want
of
it.
It,
bro. I don't want it, bro. If listen, and hear me out. Listen, if... You make pulled pork with no barbecue sauce and you just let the flavor sing. And then you take the pork out and cook it on a griddle and crisp it and put some barbecue on top and let it caramelize. Maybe. Maybe I'm with you a little bit. Maybe just a little bit. All right? Maybe.
Yeah. No, that sounds good.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
But cooking the pork in the barbecue, you're just releasing the pork flavor and mixing it with the barbecue. And at that point,
you yeah,
got a fucking soupy mess.
You're not even
mess.
Cooking it in it, though. You're just kind of – you're spreading it over the top layer, and it just melts into it. That's it. It's you're not – there's no juices from the barbecue
no,
sauce.
Don't,
but we have to agree to disagree. We've spent way too much time. How did we go on that?
I'll call my grandma right now. I'll call my fucking grandma. I'll tell her this motherfucker. And she'll be like, he doing, está haciendo qué? Like, he doing what? Barbecue?
Would you do it with chipotle mayo? Would you use a different type of
chipotle mayo?
Yeah, or like a different, like a dressing almost?
I'd use it. I mean, it wouldn't be pulled pork at that point. I'd make it differently though. I wouldn't.
So you wouldn't do it like
I would never. I would never take a cut of pork, put that motherfucker in a crock pot after it's rendered and render it out for another 12 hours with the sauce. No, that's awful.
Yeah, that sounds gross.
That's what pulled pork is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, you're just not having,
dude. The sauce does not mix with the pulled pork in the juices.
You just said we had to leave. You just said we had to drop.
I'm sorry, but you keep, you're coming. I don't think you understood what I said.
I hear you, bro.
You're not. You're only listening to what you want to listen to. dude, it does not. There's no juice of barbecue sauce in there. It's only pulled pork juices. The barbecue sauce only goes on the top little pieces of the pulled pork. It literally just melts into it. That's it.
It's too much. Too much barbecue.
Okay, all right.
It's too much.
What is the, I don't know how to transition.
I got so passionate. I'm sorry.
We're both fucking into it. Like, come on, no.
I was like, no, dude, you're not going to tell me, dude. Because pork is, dude, one of my comfort foods growing up as a kid.
Is it pork?
It's pork.
Really? I didn't get into pork till I was a little older.
My mom, bro, one of my favorite things to eat. One of my favorite things to eat, and I get so excited.
You know what was really gross for me?
What?
I used to love bologna. That was my comfort food.
Do you still fuck with bologna?
I hate it now.
I don't fuck with bologna.
I can't even smell it, dude.
It's not, I don't think, it's just like cheap meat.
I think it's plastic meat, dude. It looks fucking fake. Yeah, like, that shit's fucking ass.
It's
but
really gross.
I used to fucking bologna and cheese sandwich up to when I was like 10 years old. That was my shit.
Mm-hmm,
picnics, fucking.
That's strange.
Anything I'm going to go
strange. It's pretty normal, but I don't fuck with bologna.
Yeah.
But I was going to say, my comfort food is pernil. Do you know what pernil is?
I don't think so.
It's just a pork roast, a Hispanic pork roast. Benin, rice, a little salad, slice of avocado, bro.
That sounds pretty good.
That's it. That's my comfort food.
What it makes it a Hispanic pork roast? Is it a...
You take a pork shoulder, and that mix that I told you earlier, it's... All right, this mix that I told you is called adobo. Adobo is a spice you buy at the store.
Yeah, of course.
But no. But what I told you, where you mix the pepper, the red onion, garlic, oregano. If you want to put a bay leaf in there, you can. Usually, they just leave it there. But you blend that up. That's called adobo seasoning. That's traditional adobo.
Okay. Like
that's real adobo.
The real adobo. Okay.
That's real adobo.
All right.
So you take a pork shoulder, you leave all the fat on there, right? You slather it in adobo, you put it in an oven bag, and you put it in the oven for hours. You let that motherfucker cook. And you don't touch that bitch. You just let her cook. And when I say pork shoulder, I mean like, not pork shoulder, pork thigh.
Okay. I was thinking, I was like, I don't think that's the same.
No, it was pork thigh. So it has all the skin. It's covered in skin. Right, there's a lot of skin on it.
Yeah.
Which is the point, because you want it to sweat within the bag and then sweat within its own skin. So the skin gets crispy as anything.
Right.
And the fat renders out slowly and like reduces by half, and the meat gets all fucking tender and juicy. They take it out. They pull it, so they pull all the meat apart until it's stringy, then they throw it back in for another 30 minutes and let that cook out, and then you just got this really natural, and you put a little lime on it if you want to, cilantro, lime.
Oh, you throw onions over the top of it? I feel like
you could put red on it. A lot of people, I mean? They
that
put red
like
onions.
You could use some onion on the.
But what they do at that point, and this is the traditional Mexican stuff, is when you take that pork that's already been cooked in the oven like that, and then you put cilantro, red onion, and then you throw it on a cast iron grill.
Okay.
And then
the whole fucking.
And then
Jesus.
You crisp it up, and then you put it in a taco.
Yeah.
You know?
In that, a taco.
Yeah, a little corn tortilla.
Word. That sounds bomb.
Yeah, carnitas tacos.
I was
tacos,
thinking just
bro.
In like, on like a focaccia bread sandwich or something.
You could do
shit
a bread. You
like,
could do a sandwich.
Yeah.
It goes amazing with rice. It goes amazing with pasta. It goes amazing
Damn.
With corn tortilla.
I'm getting fucking hungry, dude. I might get food after this.
I'll make carnitas for you sometime. I'll make carnitas for you sometime. I'll learn the recipe from my mom.
So comfort-wise, do you have a comfort drink that goes with that meal? Is there something that tops it off?
Yeah.
Because I do with mine.
I do. This is going to be weird, but it's called morir soñando in Spanish. And in English, that translates to die sleeping. Because it's a drink that makes you sleepy because it's very thick. So when you drink it, you're kind of like
bloated. Die sleeping. Jesus Christ.
Basically, you take milk and orange juice and you emulsify them slowly. So you put a blender on.
What?
Yep. You take milk and orange juice and you put them in the blender and you put them in really slowly and you blend it, boop, boop, and let them mix really slowly. And by the time it's done, it's really like you take whole milk. So it's thick, it's creamy, it tastes like an orange creamsicle. They put sugar in there and they freeze it or they make a slushy out of it or they just have it as a cold drink. And it is one of the most refreshing things you can have on a hot day.
Dude, that
day.
Sounds so fucking good.
It's so fucking good.
I fucking
good.
Love whole milk it's and orange juice.
It's an orange creamsicle drink. It's called Morir Soñando.
Damn, that sounds bomb.
Yeah. That's the thing. That's like, and no one knows about it. Like, it's a really good cup
secret. I've never fucking heard of that. That's fucking.
Because it doesn't last long. It only lasts a couple hours.
Of
and
course,
then it starts to separate again.
Right.
And
yeah.
then it's really gross.
I'd imagine, exactly. Curdles and shit after a little bit if you leave it there.
Yeah, because orange juice is acidic.
Right.
And then milk is.
That's
so you,
thick ass.
You're
kind of
like
milk.
Making cheese already.
Right.
So you got to go kind of quick. But, dude, that is. A little glass of that on a hot 90 degree day with ice cubes, bro. Oh.
Yeah.
When you're done with that, you just got to sit in the sun and just.
Yeah, I feel like if I had one of those, a fat fucking meal, and then afterwards I sat there with like a pina colada, I'd be in fucking heaven, like on the beach or something.
That basically, it's a pina colada but with orange juice.
Yeah,
you know?
I mean, after that, I'd just pour myself an additional pina colada and then be like, yeah, this is the life.
Hell yeah.
You know what I mean?
That sounds
fucking nice.
Pina colada,
yeah.
Classic, bro. Coconut pineapple milk.
Yeah,
it
makes me want to fucking go back to Mexico. That was one of the other terrifying dreams I had last night, dude. Not last night, but I think it was this week. I was in fucking Mexico. God, I was like breaking someone out of something. It wasn't like a jail, though.
Okay.
It was weird. It was like a fucking, like a futuristic looking room. And it was a glass. And like they were like banging on it. And I broke them out. It was really weird. But
that's it?
Yeah. And I woke up fucking like panicked and like shook up again. I was like, what is happening? Like,
yeah, it is.
I don't know. It's strange, but.
Do you keep a dream journal?
I used to.
Yeah.
Cause I've always dreamt very vividly ever since I was really young. So
I used to too. It's a hassle to keep up with. If you work full time, it's a hassle to wake up and spend 10 minutes writing your journal.
Oh yeah. Right. That's dude, those first few minutes when you like the whole dream's fresh in your head, you're like, holy hell, that was wild.
Yeah. And but you need to write it down because within a couple minutes it's gone.
Gone completely.
Gone.
Yeah.
Have you ever had a moment where you have a dream super vivid and then later on in that day, you're trying to recall the dream, but you can't. And then months, weeks, years later, you will recall that dream perfectly.
Yes.
I've had that happen. Like, dude, I couldn't think of that dream the day of, but now years later, I'm like, oh, I remember when that dream happened.
Yeah.
I don't remember the whole thing. Strange, man. The human.
I feel like I have a dream like that. We've definitely talked about this, but I have a dream that's like kind of recurring. It's like the same type
of dream.
Yeah, we've
talked about recurring dreams.
Yeah, that I've had for like 10 years now, and it's always the same general group of people in it. Some get it added in, some get removed, and yeah, it's weird.
What happens again for a refresher?
Pretty much I'm just in like these giant either homes or like a park or just concert. It's something with a ton of people that I went to high school with and then a bunch of other people I'm close with. And like half the time we're all running from something or half the time we're all working together to get something. It's weird, but we're all always together trying to work at something.
Mm, that's how you die then.
Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like in the future, you have a high school reunion, you go, there's a terrorist attack, and two options. Either you run and die, or you try to save everybody and die. Either way, you die. That's kind of cool, though.
Yeah. That'd be cool if I was dreaming about that my whole life, and then it killed me. That'd be fucking really cool.
That'd be really cool.
Yeah. I wish I'd be able to tell someone, though.
Yeah.
Like, if you guys have recurring dreams.
You'd be like, this shit was crazy. Yeah. What the fuck? I have a recurring dream. I've already talked about this, but I have a recurring dream that I've had ever since I was a child where I'm sleeping in my grandmother's house and I hear her stumble and she's calling for help. And then I go into a room, the bed's empty, there's no one in her bed, but her bathroom light is on and it's like on the left side of the room. So I kind of like walk towards it really cautiously. And as I look into the bathroom and I get a good view, it's really bright and it's blinding. So I cover my eyes and look down. And as I look down, there's a hole. And I start falling and I look up and the world falls and that's it. That's
damn.
The dream.
I've had a similar dream to that before. But
I've had that dream
recurring?
Hundreds of times.
Oh, that's probably how you die.
Hundreds of times.
Yeah.
Well, when I'll die. I mean, dude, do you remember how it was before you were born? Like, do you remember that?
Yes, vividly.
Well, my point is, that's how it's going to be when you die.
Yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
If you can be like, oh, before I was born, it was like nothing. There was nothing. It was less than
that's
nothing.
Exactly
it was
what
super
it's
nothing.
Be.
That's exactly what it's going to be like when you die.
I hate when people are always like, oh, it's scary that it's all just going to like turn off. It's like, no, it's not because we're not going to have any idea. We're not going to exist. There's not going to be no panic, no emotion, no
so
anything.
It's so strange. And it bothers me, bro, because it's like, it's so strange.
Yeah.
You're just going to die and that's going to be it.
And everything just turns off.
And then you're just probably never, I mean, you're probably never going to come to existence again.
Yeah, probably not. I mean, saying it like that, it does sound dark.
It's dark, but it's real. I mean, the reality is when you die, there's not. I would wager money on it that it's probably going to be nothing.
Oh, no. Yeah, there's definitely nothing.
You probably just die.
There's no way that there's.
And I'd love for there to be something.
How do we always get pessimistic? Every single episode.
It's not, though, but it's realistic. It's because, dude, like. We're on a timer, man.
Yeah.
You're on a fucking timer here, guys. And you gotta, it's not about accomplishing the most. It's not about having the most money. It's about enjoying yourself. It's about creating meaningful relationships. It's about, you know, living the human experience to its finest. And a lot of people, you know, don't do that.
Yeah. I mean, people focusing on death is probably what their issue is. Just focus on all the other shit. You know?
I'd be in bed, bro.
Stop fucking worrying.
I'd be in bed thinking about dying. I'd be like, I get mad, bro.
That doesn't even enter my thoughts.
Does it really?
I'll text you next time. Yeah.
I'll text you next time I'm laying in bed and I can't sleep. I'll text you like, yo, bro, imagine dying.
Yeah. And I'll pick up my phone. I'll be like, that'd be crazy, right? Like just tomorrow we don't wake up. Like it wouldn't affect me. Like,
but it sucks though.
I don't think so. Because no one's gonna. When people around you die, it sucks. When you die, nothing happens.
You know what I mean? When you die, it. Correct. It's not gonna suck for you because you're no longer gonna exist. So there's no sucking because there is no comprehension. Yeah. You can't even define sucking within a vacuum.
Yeah, you don't have a conscious.
I get you. But it is going to suck because it's like you're going from having nothing to having something for a blip and then going back to having nothing. The losing is the sucky part.
I think thinking about it is what sucks because the only thing you can do is think about it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I've said this, but I would fight anybody to have anything. Like if God's like, listen, man, I was real the whole time.
Yeah, right?
Like,
I know,
and you never believed in me, so
you're fucked.
You're like, going to hell.
Yeah,
I'd be happy. Shit. I'd be happy with going to hell. I'll be like, oh, I'm going to be tortured for eternity.
Right.
At least I have comprehension.
At least
I'm a person because, like, I don't know. Me and devil will be homies, bro. I'll talk to him and be like, hey, what's up, dog? Like, hit me with it. What you got?
Yeah.
You know? Chop it up with him. I'll chop it up with him.
Yeah.
I have something to do for eternity, but as it stands, you're going to die, and then it's just going to be like before you were born. It's just going to be a wrap.
That would be really nice if we got a confirmation from something. You know what I mean? From anything. Yeah. You know? Just, hey, when you die, like, even if it's not a heaven and hell, you just float around on the planet. I don't know how they'd confirm that.
If you die and you just become this being that has no physical form, you can't interact with anything around you, you can go through objects, and you can fly through space. Would you stay on the planet Earth or would you go elsewhere?
Oh, fuck no. I'd go elsewhere, dude. I'd fucking
So you think you'd travel, but you'd be lost. You'd be out for millions and millions
of years. I was going to say, yeah, I'd go on an infinite, you know, I don't know. I would try to go to a planet that I know where it is.
I would be scared traveling through space.
Oh, it'd be terrifying. It'd be
terrifying.
Especially, I mean, can you go as fast as you want?
Sure.
So you can...
You can go as fast as the speed of light. Let's go and say that.
Yeah, so I'll just blip to the moon, see what it's like.
But yeah, the moon is like, there's not much in the moon.
No, I don't know. I'll look at
it. And then if you want to go anywhere farther, like, oh, let me travel the galaxy. By the time you come back to Earth, like, we'll all be dead. We'll all have joined you.
So we could go to like a star, right? And like, it wouldn't affect us because we're dead already.
Yeah.
So I'd blip to a star. I'd fucking fly up there and be like, wow, this is cool.
So you go to an inferno.
Yeah.
A burning inferno and you just sit there.
I guess.
Alone.
I mean, some of them, like, they say a lot of the stars... Actually, like planets look like stars because of how big they are, but we can't perceive it as anything else but a light. So one of those fucking lights has to be something. You know what I mean?
I guess.
There's so many of them. Like,
have you ever been in like an uncomfortable situation where you're just like you're not comfortable where you're at, you're alone, and you're just like, I need to get out of here. You ever had that panic?
Yes, definitely.
Right. It'd be like that times 10. Like I can't imagine. Flying through space for thousands of years and just being like, there's nothing around me. There's no interaction. Like, I'd go crazy.
Well, if you're traveling at the speed of light, it wouldn't take thousands of years.
Yeah, well, of course.
No, it wouldn't.
Speed of light is not that fast. It's the fastest thing we know. Who says
the speed of light is the limit, though? Like, the way I'm perceiving it is like...
Physics.
But we'll be dead, so we won't go by physics.
Yeah, but if you have comprehension... I mean, I get you.
You know what I mean? I'm thinking like we could literally basically appear there for how fast we can go. That's kind of where I'm going with it.
I mean, I'd like that. I'd like that, but it's probably not. I mean, everything in physics, the maximum speed of anything recorded is the speed of light.
Right.
And even then, it's atrociously slow.
So say, like, it'll take, what, 14 light years to travel to a planet, which is a couple billion human years. So for us to travel there as dead people at the speed of light.
14 years.
Probably, like, 14 years. That's scary as fuck, though.
Going You'd be space alone.
For 14 years?
Through darkness. And, like, there would be periods of that where
you for just, a day, I'd yeah. lose my shit. Never yeah. mind 14 years.
Imagine, yeah, you're literally in a dark room and yeah. there's nothing around you.
Nothing.
And you're not, like, going to be passing planets every couple minutes. Like, you're going to be passing nothing for a long time.
Right. I mean, you might see, like, some cool lights and gases and asteroids every now and then, but how often, you know? How, yeah. like, how close is that shit really, you know? Yeah. Like, how do you know? I don't know.
That, if that were the outcome after you die, I wouldn't hate it, but it'd still kind of suck.
Yeah, it'd be shitty.
It'd be really shitty.
Because you're pretty much forced to stay on the planet that you know exists.
Yeah.
You know? What if you fly to the moon and then you can see other shit from the moon and you're like, oh, I'm going to try going over there.
I mean,
you know,
probably would.
Never know. You know?
And then spend 50 years getting out there and come back and everybody I knew was dead.
Right.
I'm like, yeah, you're dead now? They're like, yeah, we've been waiting for you here. Bro.
Yeah, they're like, where have you been? Like,
I flew to the end of the galaxy and I yeah. came back. Like, I got bored.
What if you went to another planet that can revive, like, spirits and they bring you back on another planet? Like, you finally find somewhere and they're like...
What if when you die... That'd be sick.
Right.
What if when you die, you get a whole different dimension.
Okay.
Whereas all the people that have previously died on Earth.
The fourth dimension.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you go to another place and they're like, oh, dude, welcome. You die and you think it's all over and, like, you know, you're surrounded by your wife and your kids. And you're, like, peaceful and you did right. You're like, all right, I'm leaving you guys now. Bye. And you die.
Okay.
And then the next thing you know, you're in a room and there's some guy sitting at a desk. And he's like, hey, welcome. You are number... 13 trillion,
right.
blah, 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 blah.
Of dead.
And you're like, huh? He's like, yep.
It's like a Loki thing. Like you yeah. go somewhere and it's just, you're like an office building.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
What is this? And they're like, so
what do you guys do? And it's like, well, you do what you were doing before. You just live.
Yeah.
Until you die. And then you go to the next place.
That'd be so crazy.
And you'd be like, what?
Yeah, that'd be nuts. So if like you die, you like start... Again, do you? How old are you when you die? Are you still like 90, or do you get reset somewhere?
Let's
or
say,
can you live until like 200 at that point?
Yeah, let's say in the next dimension, time is not linear, so you don't age. You can pick an age and stay that age.
Oh, so how do you die?
Just you run out.
You run out
of juice. Yeah.
One day you just stop kicking. You're just
yeah.
Like,
one
yeah,
day you're
I'm
just
done.
Like you're like, oh, I'm falling apart. Like
okay,
like your fingers just be like, oh shit.
That okay. So after like say another 100 years, you'll just start decaying.
Yeah.
You'll just start turning into dust.
It's not.
Or
it's not. It's not time that has worn down on you. It's you've like used up all your
okay,
all your juice.
Your body's like carbon material is just
well, we're carbon based now.
Yeah. So it's just naturally fucking expiring.
Yeah,
you're
right.
A walking bone, basically.
And there's just like, dude, that'd be sick. If that's what life was all about, that'd be interesting.
That'd be pretty cool if when this ended that we had like another whole thing to do.
Yeah.
That all the people who are dead now are going through and we just don't know yet, you know?
Yeah, and you like me. Like
we get
like
there
you
and
get
they're
there
like,
and
yo!
Norm McDonald's like, yeah. Yeah, what's up?
He's like, hey. It's like they put me in charge of here now. You're yeah. the 13 trillionth guy that died.
If when you die, they had a chance, you had two choices. You can either look exactly the way you do now and pick an age, or you can random, it's called a random reroll, where you reroll,
okay.
you reroll everything.
I like that, yeah.
You can come out Asian, you can come out tall, you can come out big dick, small dick, you can come out a woman, you can come out hair, ooh. No hair, black, white, random, completely
that's
random.
That's going to be tough. Right now? I wouldn't change. I like
I'd
who I am
stay.
Now.
I'd probably
yeah.
stay the way
I
am, yeah.
But if I'm 100.
No, like, actually, I'd probably change.
But I'm thinking I'd about it. Change. Like, if I lived to 100 and died, and at that point, I'd probably be like, yeah, let's switch it up. Let's see.
That's what I'm. That's why
yes.
I changed
but
my
right
answer.
Now, no. I yeah. wouldn't. Yeah.
If you lived a whole ass life and you died, and then, like, do you want to reroll? I'd be like, you know, it's time for a fucking change.
Right,
I'm a
right.
new guy. Let's do it. And then yeah. you come out looking like a fucking. Ugly
oh,
piece
so
of
no
shit.
One would really recognize each other. So
right.
you don't know if
and,
that's
and, like,
the person
you can't
you've
remember
met.
Your name for the life of you. You can't. You remember faces. You remember events, but you don't remember names. And you just like fuck. Like I knew my name, and they like you have it on the tip of your tongue, but you can never quite grasp it.
Yeah, but you probably so you, what you'd probably get a new one at that point. Then
yeah.
you just would fit your identity, I guess.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
you,
yeah.
you don't have parents in this new world.
No.
Can you have kids?
No.
Ooh, this is interesting. This could be a good movie, dude.
You think? I mean, but it'd have to have like a plot. Like, what's the purpose of that life? And then maybe that's the whole thing.
At the end,
there's no purpose.
Exactly. It just ends.
It just ends.
So after this life, there's an afterlife that's another 100 years. But at that point, you're done.
Oh, that'd be cool. They're just like, okay, well, welcome. You got another 100 years.
Right.
This is the life force that you have accumulated during your time on Earth. After that, 100 years is up. You're done. And what do you mean? Like, oh, do I go to the next place? Like, no, you're done.
Yeah, like this is it.
This is like, you actually die after this.
Right. Like, now you're halfway there.
Like, God's real. Satan's real.
He's
not,
yeah, right.
He's not omnipotent. Like, this is God's second life too. And he just happened to live thousands of years. So he's not like this grand encompassing thing.
Okay. Right?
And you're just like, okay. And you don't know how long you're going to live until you die.
Yeah. Like, no, this is nice. So what world is this? Is this a futuristic world? Is it the same that we're dealing with now?
Parts of it are futuristic. Parts of it are and parts of it aren't.
Okay. Is it planet Earth still? It's just a fourth dimension. It's like on a plane.
No, it's a planet. You're still on a planet, but you're like in a different bubble. Like you're in a different...
It's not Earth, but it's the same setup as Earth and the sun here, but on a different
part of space. Yeah, we can go with that. Can go with that.
And that one's called?
It's called Juice.
Juice. You're on planet Juice.
You're on planet
Juice. Basically the same thing you were just used to, but when you die there, you come here.
You come here. Yeah. And you're running out of juice constantly.
You're running out of juice constantly.
Which is why they call it Juice, because once you're out of juice, you're dead.
That's the movie name.
Yeah, Juice.
Yeah, and the movie shout name out to Tupac, Juice. But yeah.
Oh, that movie was fucking crazy.
That movie was amazing.
That movie was good. That movie was fucking weird, though.
Yeah.
He just kills everybody.
Dark movie, yeah.
Really dark movie.
Right.
A lot of people would like it. A lot of people would hate it. A lot of religious people would be like, okay, I've been religious my whole life. What now? Like, no, you're on the same playing field as everybody else.
Right, yeah. You could choose to be religious in this life, but...
But it's not going to get you anywhere.
Right, but good luck.
Good luck. Like, that's God, and he's just... He's playing Fortnite, so right. You got to know.
Yeah.
God's like wearing a fedora. He's like, I've been alive for fucking thousands of years, man. I don't give a shit.
That'd be hella interesting, because on that new... place that you go to, there's probably new religions, new world governments, new wars, probably. New shit that happens, probably. You know?
Yep.
That'd be interesting.
And the weapons are not like fatal weapons, like they don't impale you, they suck your juice out. They suck out your nut juice, dude.
Okay.
Not nut
That's
juice.
Better. No, let's keep it in nut juice. Yep, let's keep it there.
So it's a very sexual society.
It is.
All right, let's move on. We're done.
Yeah. That was a crazy tangent. That was a good movie.
We're done. Someone's going to take that and make that into a movie. I want royalties.
Yeah. I mean, at least it's recorded now. We have it stamped. Okay. Thanks for tuning in.
Hey, Trey.
I don't even think we said what episode this was or anything.
Did we even do an intro?
No intro. No,
we didn't. We didn't even do a fucking intro.
I like having the intro. You got to listen to last week's, dude. The first 5 minutes, then the 3, 2, 1, and the music plays. It's dope. It's a good concept.
Word to word. Like, I like it.
Makes you feel like, okay, there is more that goes on before. And there always is more before we start recording, you know?
Yeah, we always, every single week we come in, start talking, be like, we should save that for the podcast.
Yeah. We try not to, I don't know. It's hard not to chop it up with people. Like, we're fucking, you know, trying to actually have a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for tuning in to the Brutal fucking View. This is episode 64?
68.
68? Oh, so next week is 69?
Next week is 69, the grand finale.
And then the next week is episode where we kill ourselves.
Yeah.
So if somebody else is willing to edit our podcast, because we're going to be dead.
Right. Yeah, hit us up about that.
Because we need a producer.
But hopefully we'll learn some things about the afterlife. We'll tell you. We'll try to relate. But,
well, we won't be able to tell you.
We probably won't be able to do anything.
But I mean...
Yeah, we'll see you in the next life.
If you guys want to watch someone, getting their ass ate, tune in the next episode. John is going to give it a shot. Thank you. Bye now. Thanks for tuning in.